Hey, I'm Caleb from Caleb's Aviation. Welcome back to another episode of Aviation News. There's a lot to cover today, so let's get into it. First up today, Fiji Airways will say goodbye to their Airbus A330 fleet. That's right, Fiji Airways will retire the entire A330 fleet by the end of 2025. The A330's Fiji flies aren't very old, however, so hopefully they will find a second life or different use. Unshockingly, they will be replaced by the Airbus A350, of which Fiji has started taking delivery of several years ago. The A350 taking over for the A330 isn't a huge shock, but I thought it was definitely worth covering. Also, check out my friend Paul's video on the fabulous A350. Moving right along, we have a new carrier, Riyadh Air of Saudi Arabia, planning to make their launch and appearance very soon. This new Saudi Arabian full service carrier, founded by several members from other airlines, including Etihad, aims to compete with the big carriers in the Gulf, being Etihad, Qatar, and Emirates. It will certainly be a tall order, but I wish them the best of luck. Additionally, Aeromexico will say goodbye to the Embraer 190 fleet. More specifically, Aeromexico Connect, the subsidiary that flies the Embraer 190, and have done so since 2005. They have several units in their fleet, currently more than 20 of them, used on short to medium haul domestic services. They will be replaced with the 737 MAX. That could be good or bad, depending on how you want to look at it. The next piece of major aviation news comes in the form of Korean Air. They have announced they will sell 5 Boeing 747-8s to U.S. military corporation Sierra Nevada. These new 747s that have been converted will be going off to the U.S. Air Force to become the E-4B's replacement. The E-4B, or the Doomsday Plane as it's commonly known, has flown for many years, and the 747-8 will be its natural successor. It makes sense to stick with the 747, and the current fleet is based off the ancient 747-200 series. The 747-8 will bring improvements in fuel burn, range, efficiency, and a new two-crew glass cockpit. For comparison, the 200 first entered service in 1971. As of 2024, there are very few left. GeoSky flies two 747-200 freighters, and a couple are preserved in museums around the world. The current Air Force One 747s will also be replaced by different 747-8s. Korean retiring these 747s unfortunately also means they're one step closer to retiring the full fleet. Also, Korean airline Asiana also retired their last 747 recently as well. Just worth mentioning. Next, we have some more exciting news, as Emirates and Colombian carrier Avianca have announced a code share agreement and partnership today. By doing so, Emirates will hope to expand capacity into Central and South America with connections operated by Avianca. Avianca also hopes to possibly expand service to places like Dubai, flying a similar fleet to Emirates in the coming years. They also fly the A320neo aircraft and are based at Bogota El Dorado International Airport. This is also good news for Emirates and United's partnership to maybe expand more in South America. Also, this could mean some hope for Emirates joining Star Alliance someday. This puts them one step closer and could be a very good thing for travelers in the end. Well, that's all I have for you in this short installment of Aviation News. I hope you've enjoyed. If so, make sure to subscribe to my channel, ring the notification bell, and leave me a comment. I'd really appreciate it. However, that's going to do it for me. You know the drill. As always, we're wishing you blue skies and tailwinds.